Hello, welcome to Travelzilla. Make sure to follow us on social media. Previously on Travelzilla, we've listened to the sounds of Istanbul. Gave tips on the cheapest way to get to the city center. Experienced the hammam or Turkish bath. Saw Leander's Tower on our way to Asia, where we explored Kadıköy, the cultural hub of the Asian side of the city. Had a great time visiting Topkapi Palace and its harem. We were in awe by the mesmerizing beauty of Hagia Sophia and were hypnotized by the beauty of the Blue Mosque. After getting involved in an intergalactic space battle and having the best time on Istiklal Avenue, what else could we do? I know, let's visit the Grand Bazaar and go on a shopping spree. The Basilica Cistern is the largest of several hundred ancient sites that lie beneath the city of Istanbul. It's located 150 meters or 500 feet from Hagia Sophia. Its name derives from a large public square on the first hill of Constantinople, the Stoa Basilica, beneath which it was originally constructed.
A gente está agora na Basílica Cisterna de Istambul, que era onde eles costumavam guardar a água aqui, escondido. Isso aqui era um tesouro escondido que foram descobrir séculos depois. E eles esvaziaram a basílica para que a gente pudesse ver. Olha que incríveis as pilastras, em estilo coríntio, enfim, fantástico.
The cistern provided a water filtration system for the Great Palace of Constantinople that doesn't exist anymore, and continued to provide water to the Topkapi Palace after the Ottoman conquest of Constantinople in 1453. This underground structure is as grand as a cathedral. On the northwest corner of the cistern, one finds the world-famous two Medusa heads carved on the basis of two columns. The cistern has several carvings spread throughout this incredible historic site. Now, let's go back to the Hippodrome and check out the Museum of Turkish and Islamic Art. Just across from the Basilica Cistern on Sultan Ahmed Square, you can still see a few pieces of what used to be part of the Hippodrome. Today, all that remains are some of the old Egyptian obelisks, one of the few fragments of the original structure. One attraction you can't miss is the Museum of Turkish and Islamic Art on the Hippodrome across from the Blue Mosque. A As you enter, you go through the museum store. The place is a treasure house of beautiful objects from various eras of Turkish history. It was restored and reopened in early 2015. There, the best art is religious, but you can also find very intricate Turkish carpets, illuminated Qurans, calligraphy, carved and inlaid wood, glass, porcelain, and stones. After a lot of walking, we decided to try as many different dishes and sweets as possible, so we went to a restaurant on Divan Yolu Street. Come along and you're gonna see, we had a feast. We ate so much. Actually, when I saw the menu, I saw pictures of the dishes, and to me, I thought the dishes were small, and then we ordered everything. When they arrived, what a surprise, they were all huge. Check this out.
I think we've ordered too much. Fala em português, meu amigo.
Acho que pedimos demais.
Pedimos muito.
After eating so much we could barely move, we decided to walk to the world-famous Grand Bazaar. The Grand Bazaar is one of the largest and oldest covered markets in the world, with 61 covered streets and over 4,000 shops.
This place is massive. It's huge.
Which attract between 250 and 400,000 visitors daily. The Grand Bazaar is often regarded as one of the world's first malls. The construction of the Grand Bazaar started in 1455, shortly after the conquest of Constantinople by the Ottoman Turks, but it only achieved its final shape at the beginning of the 17th century. You want to see what the Grand Bazaar has to offer? Come along, I'm going to show you around.
Mm-hmm.
Istanbul is home to many great modern malls, the largest of them being the Sivahir. But there are some newer high-end design malls as well. Don't forget to have a look and go shopping. Do your research before you go to Istanbul. It's definitely a great place to go shopping. The Sivahir is one of the world's largest malls. As you can see, it's huge, with hundreds of shops. At the Eminönü neighborhood, you can also find the Spice Bazaar, the second largest covered market in Istanbul. This is a great spot to get souvenirs, and of course, spices. The construction of the building started soon after Istanbul's Great Fire in the 1660s. This is a great place for you to get Turkish delight, the famous sweets of Istanbul.
Mas o azul é lindo também. Vamos levar uma mistura. Olha esse, que lindo. Esse. After visiting the Spice Bazaar and doing some shopping, we decided to go on a Bosphorus tour. But before that, I want to show you more of the Eminönü area, including its gorgeous mosque called the New Mosque or Yeni Mosque. Check out the area though, it's pretty cool and I love this statue. The mosque is one of my favorite in the city. It was built in the 1660s when it was severely damaged in the Great Fire. Later, it was reconstructed into its current setup, which also includes the Spice Bazaar. Come with me and I'm going to show you what it looks like, at least in the courtyard.
Ui!
Well, I have to say something to you. To me, I love this mosque because you get to see everybody like the way it used to be.
Next on Travelzilla, we'll walk all the way from the new mosque in Eminönü to Istiklal Avenue and walk across the famous Galata Bridge. It's the perfect way to go fishing in the center of one of the world's largest cities, I'll tell you that. We'll show you the famous Galata Tower. Go on a boat tour of the Bosphorus and show you some of the main attractions in that part of the city. Try some sahlep again, of course, it's one of the best winter drinks ever. Check out some of the city's main bridges. Take you to the Dolmabahçe Palace. And of course, we'll check out the neighborhood of Ortaköy, a very artsy and cool neighborhood of Istanbul. Hey, don't forget to drop a like, make a comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you so much for your time, guys. See you soon. Goodbye.